Okay, we're going to make up a batch of black powder. We're going to make about a pound. This is our mill jar. And these are the lead balls. You can see. So first thing we do is take the lead balls and put them in the mill jar. We put the balls in first, chemicals on top of that. So what I did was I filled the mill jar about half full of lead balls. That's optimum. Then we want to fill half of the remaining space, which is about to here, with chemicals. Okay, the chemicals are pre-measured in the right proportion, 75, 15, 10. We're going to dump them in, and I'm using prilled potassium nitrate that's chunky. So we're just going to throw it in just like it is. There's the sulfur. And carefully, I put the air float charcoal in. Try not to get it all over everything. And I put the cap on it. I'll screw it down real tight. And the way this mill jar works is I've got to attach this cap really tightly. So to make sure this cap doesn't come off, I'm going to use electrician's tape to tape it on. And I'm going to put a lot of tape on there to really keep that thing from twisting off. Because in this particular ball mill, the screw-on cap has been known to come off. I'm using a primitive ball mill. I'll show you. And I want to put enough tape on there so that I know that top is not going to unscrew while we're ball milling. It probably wouldn't be the end of the world if it unscrews. But I know my powder wouldn't be very good. And it could cause an explosion hazard. Now Bert is walking the whole ball mill and all the gear about 200 feet away. And you see this drop cord? You got 200 feet of cord going all the way out in the field. He's gonna plug that ball mill in at the end of the drop cord. Now I put it this far away so that if it goes off, for any reason, it's going to be 200 feet away from my house, my shop, and even this guy on the lawnmower. You can see how far away I am from the house. I'm going to show you. The house is here behind me. So we put it safely down at the end of the field. Okay, so we've got the ball mill set out in the field. And we're on 200 feet of this yellow drop cord, and we turn the ball mill on, not down at the ball mill, but up here at the workshop. So Bert's just going to plug it in now, and when he plugs it in here, that turns the ball mill on. And then when we're finished, we're going to wait 4 hours. It's about noon. We're going to come back at 4 o'clock. We're going to run this for 4 hours, and then we'll just unplug this and we'll let it sit, the ball mill, for about 15 minutes, just to cool down. All right, I just made a batch of black powder, ran it for 3 hours. This is the ball mill jar we've got, and it's right down full of lead balls and finished black powder. So we're gonna take it out of the, we're gonna take the jar, which we've taken off of the ball mill. I'm gonna dump it in, separate the balls from the black powder. That's the next step. So we'll do that right now. This thing weighs probably about 30 pounds. It's amazingly heavy. It's half full of lead balls, and it's got about that much powder in it on top of that. That's the optimum. This screen is pretty well broken up, but as you can see, what I've got is I've got some quarter inch chicken wire screen down in the bottom of this, and we put it on this bucket with these stops. And so you take this bucket, you put it in another 5 gallon bucket, and it fits just like that. It'll sit still while I pour the black powder and the balls in there, and that'll separate the balls out. So here we go. You can see this is pretty dusty. There's still dust coming out of the mill jar. So you definitely want to do this outdoors. You want to do it someplace where there's not any danger of fire or sparks. And you can see the lead balls have separated out. And when I lift the sieve out, I got the lead balls, and I got fine black, just like talcum powder, black powder, down in the bottom. That's how you make black powder.